Hey everyone, today we will carve mandibular first molar tooth. It is mesiodistally widest tooth at the mandible. Cervical occlusal dimension is short. First we will draw our cervical line according to the ratios. Mesiodistal and bacolingual thickness almost same. If crown length is 2 units, mesiodistal width and bacolingual thickness will be 3 units. So we will draw our lines here. It gets narrower to the cervical line. From the buccal aspect, 2 buccal and 1 distal tubercle can be seen. It looks like tulip. Towards the distal and lingual, the tooth gets narrowed at the occlusal surface, so we will cut here. When we look from distal, buccal face is convex. Around 1/3 middle, we will cut like this. Lingual face will be flat or a little bit tilted to the lingual. Now we will shape corners of the tooth. We will round each corner and get a smooth shape. Mesiodistal width on the lingual surface is shorter than buccal, which means the tooth gets narrower throughout the lingual. Lingual surface is relatively smoother. Now we can start occlusal morphology. First, we will divide each tubercle. We have 2 tubercles on the lingual side. We can divide like this. And here on buccal, we draw tip of the tubercles. Okay, here we have 5 tubercles, 2 on lingual, and 3 on the buccal, like this. Now I start carving like a C shape each tubercle. It's easier than maxillary molars. Also, you can use small carver for better accuracy. The mesial and distal tubercles, which form the lingual surface, are at the same size. Lingual tubercles are sharper and higher than the buccal tubercles. Two tubercles are separated by lingual developmental groove. This groove is shorter than the buccal developmental groove. Now we will open these grooves. We will divide here, almost like V shape. We will also carve buccal face here. So we have three tubercles on the buccal. So we have two V letters on the buccal, like this. Of course, we will sharpen our tubercles later on. I fast-forwarded here occlusal carving, but also you can reduce playback speed from settings, so you can watch carefully if you want. Then we will clean our carving with a sponge. Now we will create our developmental grooves on buccal, mesiobuccal and distobuccal grooves. And also lingual groove, lingual developmental groove. The rest of it, fine-tuning. Crown is inclined lingually according to root axis. Mesiobuccal tubercle is the largest tubercle and distal tubercle is the smallest one. Mesiolingual and distolingual tubercles almost same. Always clean occlusal morphology with a small carver. Soap remnants will block your fossas and it will look worse. Then use sucks and satin to polish. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.